Had a science fiction replicator to replicate tools. A tool on Earth all of a sudden appears in space. That would be pretty cool, but we don't have that yet.
Or do we? Theoretical physicist David Kaplan has found a company that replicates tools, and pretty much anything else you can imagine, with a 3D copy machine.
I'm in Burlington, Massachusetts at the Z Corporation, where they've developed a new technology that's similar to those replicators you see in sci-fi movies. It's called 3D printing. I'm here to find out if they can 3D print my crescent wrench.
We're one of the world's leading manufacturers of three-dimensional printers. Everything on the table in front of us has been printed in one of the machines behind us.
Printed?
Yes.
Okay.
Most printers will print things in two dimensions. A three-dimensional printer will then take that to the third dimension and make it something you hold in your hand.
Okay, I don't get it. And this?
That's just an example of the complexity of the things that you can make.
This moves.
It moves, and it was printed all as one piece.
This came out of a printer just like this?
Came out of a printer just like that.
What is the material that makes this thing?
It's a specially engineered composite material that starts out as a powder, then we add to it a binder material that solidifies those powder particles together.
These materials are the company's own secret recipe, a unique concoction not used anywhere else.
This is one of our three-dimensional printers. There's a print head inside this machine that ejects specific fluids for coloring different parts.
Yeah.
But we also have a print head for printing our binder materials to solidify the parts.
Oh, my God. The powder is the paper, and this binding stuff is the ink.
And then this tray here that it prints on will actually drop into the machine to give it that third dimension.
Okay, I would like to see that. Could you reproduce this wrench?
Absolutely.
It has moving parts here.
Not a problem. First thing we need to do is scan it.
All right.
You take a look?
Yeah. Let's see it.
Here we go.
The scanner inputs every facet of the wrench into this computer, creating an image that will be sent to the printer.
Oh, that is cool. How accurately can you measure the shape?
The accuracy is within 40 microns.
That's like a human hair width.
Actually, a little less.
That's incredible. All right, so their wrench was scanned.
Here's the wrench that you did.
Okay, can you make that ring red?
Sure, I want to select it and paint, so now that piece is red.
I see.
Just that simple. When we're ready, we just go down and hit print. All right, David, printing's done.
Okay.
Let's take a look at your wrench.
I'm ready. Okay, I don't see anything.
It's in there. Just reach into the powder and pull out your wrench.
Okay. Holy cow. Wow.
Yeah, there's a real wrench right there.
Oh my God, you printed this.
Yeah, came right out of the powder.
That's amazing.
So all that's left to do is blow off the rest of that powder.
That is cool.
Yeah.
A color 3D printer. I'm freaked out by this. It doesn't make sense. I'm holding this thing that is moving parts and it just came out of a printer. Wow.
It's just that easy.
This changes everything. So how strong can this thing get?
You could get strength just by infusing this with a little extra resin.
We could actually use it as a tool?
Absolutely.
Okay, let's see if this really works. Can I really pull it hard?
Go for it, just as you would a real wrench.
Okay.
What do you think?
Wow. That's a real tool?
Yeah.
Holy cow. We just printed this.
That's right. An hour and a half ago, that was nothing but a bunch of powder and binder.
There's a box of powder. That's
right.
That is incredible.
Now you've got a real tool that you can use for functional tasks.
So going into space, you take a printer, and you can just print whatever you want.
That's right. Anything from the tools that you need or the actual object you're working on.
And I can keep the tool?
Absolutely.
Okay.
Print another one.
Okay, good. So if you lose your tool in space, you can print out another one.